When I get on my holiday, the first thing I want to eat is seafood.
One of the most incredible things that you could ever see in any restaurant is a classic fruit de mer. But we're not in a restaurant, so we're gonna do an amazing version of it here in the bottom of my garden on a barbecue.
You might think that the barbecue is a difficult way to cook such delicate ingredients, but actually, it's so simple and so easy. And you're already ahead of the game if you start with high-quality, fresh produce. I'm using the best from British waters, with hand-dived scallops and razor clams, Cornish oysters, jig-caught squid, tiger prawns, and mighty Scottish langoustines.
Now, there is a bit of a price that comes with shellfish, particularly when it's this good. But you know what? As a one-off kind of occasion, it really is worth spending that bit of money.
Most of this shellfish I'll be cooking whole and in their shells, but some things need a little bit of prep. Trim the scallops, keeping the white flesh and the coral roe. Cut open the squid, scrape and score. And then the tentacles. Just gonna cut them in half and I'm done. Time to start cooking.
So the oysters, they're gonna go on first, but they're not gonna go on top of the grill. I'm just gonna place them very close to the coals. They'll gently steam with the heat all around them. I'm gonna put my razor clams onto the top of the grill. And these guys will cook pretty much like in their own juices. And as they roast and steam, they'll open up. I'll stick my langoustines on. It looks spectacular, doesn't it? Shellfish steaming on hot coals. Just get rid of this tray of water and ice. Just throw it over next door.
Can't do that in the kitchen. Next on are the tiger prawns.
The great thing about shellfish or fish like this is it doesn't really need much else doing to it.
The delicate flesh takes on the smoky flavours of the charcoal, which is why the barbecue is such a special way to cook it.
We're going to cook it really simply and serve it with three different butters that take everything from being this beautiful shellfish into different parts of the world.
First is a Japanese seaweed butter with dried nori seaweed flakes, crushed fennel seeds, pink peppercorns, and salt.
Fantastic.
The second is a spicy Mediterranean butter with smoked paprika and andouille, an Italian chorizo-style sausage paste.
That butter is the most vibrant red. It's incredible.
And the final butter is Thai-inspired with chopped coriander, fish sauce, lemongrass paste, and a finely chopped bird's eye chili.
You do not want big chunks of this, all right? It will blow your mind.
I'll randomly brush each piece with one of the butters, and your guests can take their pick. A bit of a seafood lucky dip. And first to brush are the oysters.
Just gonna turn the langoustines over. The tiger prawns, look at them. They're now beginning to go that wonderful pink and reddy colour where they're cooking.
The fierce heat of the barbecue is ideal for cooking seafood quickly and to perfection.
My razor clams are cooked. They've opened up. See how quick and easy that was? The oysters are bubbling away. I can see that they're cooked and ready to go.
The prawns are next to come off. And finally, the langoustines, a pale pink, firm and done.
And these guys just sit, keep nice and warm underneath the grill.
Last to cook of my seafood feast are the squid and the scallops.
Just put the butter on into the shell and put the shells directly into the coals. The shell will act as a kind of a saucepan for the scallop. It will steam in its own juices and fry a little bit in the butters. I mean, this is exciting. This is what it's about. Cooking on open coals, looking at scallops like that bubbling away in its own seaweed butter. What a joy and a delight.
Scallops only take a few minutes to cook. Once they go from translucent to opaque, they're done.
Now you really, really shouldn't be afraid of cooking on coals. It's very forgiving. It doesn't really matter if things get overcooked because everything you're doing is all about the flavour. You're getting extra flavour from the coals.
The final thing to go on is the squid, as it takes no time at all. A rub with olive oil, some salt, pepper, and the squid goes on score side down. and I'm not wasting those tentacles. They're going on too.
I'm finding out very quickly that tentacles are not the easiest things to cook on a grill, but that's okay. That lovely little bit of charcoal flavour never hurt anyone.
The squid just needs a minute on each side as it rolls up into a lovely cigar shape. Then on with the butters, one flavour for each squid.
I love the smell of grilled squid like this. It's such a holiday smell.
Cooking done. I just need to build the platter. First thing on is a layer of samphire.
Now, samphire, it's a beautiful sea vegetable. It grows in salt marshes and it's absolutely delicious.
Next up are the scallops and the langoustines.
Barbecued shellfish. Those shells create such a fantastic kind of aroma. It smells of the sea.
Layer up with the prawns, the oysters, the razor clams, and finally the squid.
I'm going to rescue these squid tentacles from the coals. Stick these guys in and around the platter. And they have coal tinges on them. Oh, that squid tentacle was lovely. I should have just stuck them straight in the coals. Squid tentacles, don't bother doing them on the grill. Stick them straight in the coals. They taste fantastic. They cook up beautifully. And it's a winner.
Serve with some lemon wedges and don't waste any leftover butter. Warm it and serve it on the side for extra dipping.
People can grab their langoustines, crack the tails open, dip them in and help themselves. And that is a fantastic centerpiece, cooked on a barbecue.
The rain has stopped and the sun has come out in time for my Caribbean pudding.
Well, I'm going to be doing grilled pineapple with a lovely, sweet, sticky, very naughty toffee sauce.
And I'm cooking this on my fire pit.
If you're going to cook a dessert on a barbecue, got to make sure that it's quite simple, because I haven't got any of the KitchenAid equipment. I haven't got an oven. I've just got a hot surface with some coals.
And my dessert really is super simple.
I've got here a pineapple, and I've kept the leaves on it, and I've trimmed up all the outer skin. To give it a basting as I roast it, I want to create a lovely nutty butter. So in here, I have 80 grams of butter, and I'm just going to put that on to get hot.
And whilst that's melting down, I'll start my other sauce, the naughty rum caramel. That starts with 130 grams of dark muscovado sugar, 30 grams of butter,
and then 150 mils of double cream.
Over a gentle heat, that will turn into a rich, sweet caramel. I'm turning this into a delicious salted caramel with lots of flaky sea salt. And to give it its Caribbean flavour,
a good glug of dark rum. And that's it. Leave it to one side.
Caramel's done. Final touch to my basting butter is a squeeze of lime and some zest. Ready for my pineapple, which I've cut into quarters.
I've got the green leaves on, so it still works, kind of like a handle. Give it a little brush that butter, on it goes. It's gonna be absolutely delicious. Lovely, stunning looking, fantastic pineapples.
Serve with a good drizzle of the salty rum caramel sauce, some roasted pecan nuts, and for a real taste of the Caribbean, toasted coconut.
You know, the only thing that would make that even more special, some coconut ice cream. I'll go get some.
Luckily, I have a well-stocked freezer.
I mean, it just looks so lovely. The warm pineapple, super sweet, super amazing. That sauce is great. The one thing that really does bring this to life, that limey butter that's been basted all over it. What a special ending to a very special meal.